गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आवर सेकेंड लाइव वीडियो क्लास. ओके, एंड लास्ट वीडियो क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द यूनिटी इन डाइवर्सिटी. व्हाट इज डाइवर्सिटी? एंड वी हैव स्टार्टेड दिस पार्ट दैट टाइप्स ऑफ डाइवर्सिटी. ओके, एंड टुडे आई विल डिस्कस विथ यू द डाइवर्सिटी इन स्पोकन लैंग्वेजेस. India is a country where various languages are spoken by people living in different parts of the country. The Constitution of India recognizes 22nd scheduled languages. How many languages? 22nd scheduled languages actually Constitution recognizes. Hindi and English, these two languages actually continue to be used as official languages. So which is our official languages? Two languages we are using in official language purpose, that is, one is Hindi and another is English. Next is diversity in a culture and religion. We know that India is home to a myriad of cultures, traditions and religions. So actually in India we have so many cultures, we have people are there, so many traditions are there and so many religions are there. Each state in India follows its own culture that is markedly different from other states. For example, the culture of Assam is different from the culture of Gujarat. Likewise, different religions are also followed by people in India. So actually in India actually there are different types of cultures are there. So as per the state we followed our cultures. Each religion has its own beliefs, customs and festivals. Yes, we follow our festivals only. So every different of people, every different states people, they are followed their festivals, their customs only. Festivals like Dashera, Muharram, Christmas, Diwali, Buddha Jayanti, Eid, etc. are observed by people belonging to different faiths. List the different ways in which people do the following things in India. Some possible answers are already given. So you can see that here one box is given and some portion are filled up and some are totally empty. So empty portion we have to fill up later. Now there is some questions also there, quick revision one, and here we can see the five questions, but these five questions also we will solve later. Now case study one. In this case study today about Kerala we are going to discuss. Kerala lies on the southern west coast of India. It's famous for its pleasant climate, beaches and scenic beauty, that means scenery. Okay, so much that means side beauty you can say. So much so that it is aptly called God's own country. So Kerala is known as God's own country. The first state in India to have 100% literacy rate. Christians, Hindus, Muslims, people belonging to many other faiths live here. So not only Keralian but also the Christians, Hindus, Muslims and so many religions people lived over there. Kerala is situated between the Arabian Sea and the Western Ghats. Rice, coconut, many types of spices, bananas, etc. grow here. In fact, spices made in the favorite destination of traders in ancient times. So, it is actually situated between the Arabian Sea and the Western Ghats, and rice, coconut, many types of spices, bananas. So, all these things are grown over there. In fact, spices made in favorite destination of traders. So actually, traders go to Kerala for the spices. Actually, they go to Kerala for spices. Kerala is also known for certain cash crops such as tea, coffee, rubber, and rubber and tapioca, which are exported to other countries. Fishing is also an important occupation. So, which is very important occupation? Fishing. The fishing nets which used by the Keralian, it's known as Chenna Vela. Vala is known as Chenna Vala. Chenna, it refers to China. This is because they look similar to one used in China. Besides this, Kerala also has flourishing coir industry. Coir mattress made from the husk of coconuts are of the best quality. Okay, the presence of a large number of rivers led the growth of Kerala. It also slopes a lot of foreign influence in its culture. Jews, Europeans and Arabs came here as traders. So, they came in Kerala trading, actually trade purpose. It is quite clear from history that when foreigners settled down in one place, they spread their religious teaching as well. For instance, so actually they spread their religion teaching as well. Now, Saint Thomas, the first century traveler who brought Christianity to Kerala Christianity to India in that time, Vasco da Gama, a Portuguese sailor, also came to Kerala and can be given the credit for beginning the spice trade between India and Western world. Okay, so Vasco da Gama, Portuguese sailor, also came to Kerala and be given the credit for beginning spice trade between Indian and Western world. So in between these two country, actually business was started with the spices. Okay, they export and import the Keralian spices. Now, our next case study 2 is Ladakh. Now, we came to know about the Ladakh. Ladakh is one of the land of high passes and lies in the eastern part of Jammu and Kashmir. It is inhabited by people of Indo-Arabian and Tibetan descent. It is one of the most thinly populated region in Jammu and Kashmir. Ladakh is known as the cold desert. So, Ladakh is a cold desert. Now, one common occupation of the people of Ladakh is rearing the sheep. They look after the sheep. They rear the sheep. Why? Because from sheep actually they got the wool, and which is known as Pashmina wool. And from them Pashmina wool, those who are the Kashmirian, they woven Pashmina shawl, and it is very much costly. Most families own goat, cows, yak cows, also known as does. People's diet include meat and milk products. Now, this Ladakh is known as Little Tibet. Okay, there are many passes in Ladakh which made it very popular trade route actually. So, Ladakh is very popular trade route. And Ladakh is also known as Little Tibet. The Kesar Saga, this is the Tibetan national epic. We have also the two epics, you know, Ramayana and Mahabharata. And here, Kesar Saga is the Tibetan national epic. This is very much important. Now, our chapter is complete. So, नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस क्वेश्चन आंसर पार्ट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो थैंक यू.